My dear friends, today I asked you all the question yesterday. Do you know the meaning of the fourth factor? And would anybody who would like to try what it means? I think some of you know it, but would you like to try? It's a little tricky subject. Who would like to try? What is the fourth factor? Anybody? On the path of enlightenment.
And it is God's grace. God's mercy.
How do you explain that, Ashok? If you just say God's grace is there everywhere, all the time. What is the meaning of the fourth factor?
Sir, can I try answering?
Yeah, please try, Sudeep.
Sir, God's grace is always there, but then your efforts have to be up to a particular level. And then if there's kind of a gap which has been left out, then the God's grace can come to your rescue. It's like getting the grace marks in the university. So you get a grace marks. In my days, it used to be 4 or 5 marks. But you will get those grace only when you get 38 out of 40 or out of 100. Then you get a 2 marks grace. If you get 30, you don't get that grace. So that's one way of looking at it. Otherwise, like sunlight is always there, but not everybody uses that sunlight. So that could be another way of looking at the grace.
So, yes, but I would like you all on the path of enlightenment to understand this in a very different manner. So I know this book is very difficult to read and understand. The book is written. There's a book. I don't know how many of you have read this book. The book is called The Fourth Factor. There's a book. But even for me to explain, it's difficult in the book. It's like that. Should I explain? Anybody else wants to try? Anybody has read the book? Sudeep tried to explain it. And he's not wrong. He's right. But it's difficult for you all to understand. Samita, have you read the book? Samita, Sanjay Das, you all know? Rajendra Bhakwana? Okay, let me explain to it. Let me get to explain, right? So here it is. If a man wants to do anything, there are 3 factors required for anything to be done. Are we clear? If anything has to be done, there are 3 factors. Let me explain. The farmer wants to plow his land. So you need the farmer. First, you need the farmer. Then you need the land. You need the land and you need the fertilizers. You need the soil. And then you need the act of plowing. If he doesn't plow, then it can't happen. Clear? I mean, are we clear that there are 3 actions required? Let's give an example of the painter. Now, if you want to do a painting, you need a painter. Without the painter, how can we make painting? And the second is you require the canvas and the paints. And the third is the act of painting. Now, are we clear about it? For any action in this world, how many factors are involved? 3 factors. Without 3 factors, you cannot attain anything. You can take for a surgeon. If you want a surgery, for the surgery, you need one, you need a surgeon. 2, you need the equipments. You need the equipment to do the surgery. And 3, it is the act of doing the surgery. So these are the 3 factors responsible. But what in the spiritual, I think this is by Adi Shankara. It is in a book called Upadesa Sara. For those who want to, it is in a book called Upadesa Sara. I was inspired by that book. What he says in this book, and please understand this. Suppose Sudeep Bhargava, Rajendra Makwana, and Kumar Swami, all the 3 take the same canvas and the same paint and follow the same process. Will they all 3 make the same painting? Why not? Let me explain to you. So there's a McDonald's restaurant. The same McDonald's restaurant may be in Bombay, Delhi, Calcutta, anywhere. They follow the same method. The same McDonald's restaurant, the same hamburger, the same French fries, wherever it is, comes exactly same. There's no difference. Now the point is this. While even in a McDonald's restaurant, this is happening, suppose there is a factor beyond the control of McDonald's that in one particular consignment, the French fries, the potato is rotten. Who is responsible for that now? Now, for example, there are three farmers. There are three farmers, and all the three farmers are doing the same thing. But in one farmer, there are certain, in that particular farm, 100 rats came and ate away all the plants. How can you justify that? So this is what they say. There is a fourth factor. The fourth factor, which is beyond our control. It is beyond the control of karma also. So there is factor one, factor two, factor three, which are the responsible for any result, any action. But there is a fourth factor. And if we don't understand the power of the fourth factor, this fourth factor may also be called your past karma. Three people are doing actions, karma in their there are three factors involved. Three doctors. You know, sometimes the doctor will tell you, I perform a surgery, the same surgery I perform to 10 patients. Same problem, same age, same problem. I use the same method of surgery, same equipment. 8 people, they survive, 2 people, they die. Have you heard this? Very common. And the doctor says, I don't know why. There's so many doctors' interviews. If you see, the doctor says, I don't know. I did the same surgery, same patient, same problem. Why 2 people died? I don't know. So there is a factor in spirituality we should understand. There is a factor which is called the fourth factor. The factor is beyond man's comprehension. And this is very important to understand. Those who live a spiritual life, they live a life of surrender. They know. Prabhu ki Icha. They call it God's will, the divine will. Normally the divine will not change. Normally the divine will go as per karma. But suppose sometimes you have lot of prayer, lot of bhakti. It can change the fourth factor. The fourth factor can come in your favor. So there is a fourth factor, which is three painters are painting, same canvas, same painting, three painters, the same teacher has taught the three painters. One person gets the world award, the Nobel Prize or the Oscar award for that painting. Why other two people didn't get? Same teacher, same canvas, same painting. Why they didn't get? Nobody can explain. So let us, do we have questions? Sudeep Bhargava.
Sir, you partially answered my question in what you just said, but I just want to reaffirm it from you. Can the fourth factor be called as a result of the karma also? Although you said it's beyond karma.
It because can be.
Some people can misinterpret to be the luck factor also then.
See, understand, it's not luck. Luck is, let's define the meaning of luck. Luck is not, this is not an act of random results. The fourth factor is an organized power. Luck is not like that, no. Luck is, good luck. No, random. No, luck is different, Sudeep.
No, so I do not believe in luck. After listening to you, I've stopped believing in luck. It's like zero for me. So it's
you must believe in luck. You must believe in luck. Only when you're writing luck, you must write K-A-R-M-A. You must write, you must not write L-U-C-K. You must write, when you say, it is your good K-A-R-M-A. Then you can say, other people can read, it's your good luck. But you write, yes, good K-A-R-M-A. Spelling of luck is K-A-R-M-A. So the point is this, the fourth factor may be your past life karma. But when it is not your past life karma, it can be your bhakti. It can be the divine grace. So there is a fourth factor which is beyond man's comprehension. But it can be karma. It may very well be karma. Suppose I am saying, according to me, it may be divine grace. Maybe there's no divine grace at all. Maybe it's only karma. Maybe even the act of prayer becomes a karma.
There's a very famous incident, sir. I don't know if anybody knows about this, or otherwise you can Google it because it's a slightly long story. There was a football match, I think in 1986, between Argentina and some other country, where Maradona took the ball almost from the center and up to the goalpost, and he used his head to do the goal. But in the photographs, it was seen that there was a hand which is putting the ball inside the goalpost. And his hands were also visible. So it was a very big controversy during that time. And Diego Maradona at that time gave a very good word. He said, this is the hand of God. And that goal was actually considered, and Argentina won that match. So it's a very famous thing. And you can Google it, hand of God. Maybe it's something to do with the fourth factor.
So sometimes you can't explain it. Some things you can't explain. Sometimes let me give you another example since you say this. I know cases. We have a hospital. I know how many of you know we have three ashrams. And in one ashram, we used to run a hospital. Now it's cut down. We have reduced the hospital. But there are cases in Bangalore where a patient was sent out of five hospitals saying, no chance. Patient will die any moment. Doctors, what they say, gave up hope. And they came to our hospital. And after 2 months, 3 months, the patient walked out of the hospital perfectly okay. Doctors in five professional hospitals, best hospital in Bangalore, said, we give up hope. There is no chance. There was one lady, she committed suicide. Another case. When she committed suicide, her this vocal cord, her neck, everything got completely smashed, completely gone. So doctor again said, she'll be a vegetable for the rest of their life. After 6 months, she started singing. How to explain it? Okay, questions? Datatre.
Yes. Sir, how to open the realize? I know that I am the divine soul, but I cannot realize. Please help.
How to open the realize? Correct. By closing your two eyes.
I see.
When you close these two eyes, then what happens? Then one of your important sense gets cut off. Then you contemplate more. You open the real eyes. I'm just giving an example. Don't take literally what I'm saying. When you actually, when we close our senses, when we shut off the senses and we shut off the mind, then we open our real eyes. We have to shut off the sama-dama. Sama-dama means controlling the mind and controlling the senses.
Okay.
In the Upanishads, it's called Shat Sampat. Shat, because you're reading a lot, no? So it is called Shat Sampat, which means Sama-dama, Uparati, Titiksha, Shraddha, Samadhana. The six, they are called the six virtues. So, see what when we, I think you're reading from my book. You're reading, we open realize from one of some of my book or from where you're reading.
How to open your books,
my book, right?
From your book,
because I use the term a lot. How to realize the truth? You can realize the truth when you open your real eyes. Real eyes means not these real eyes, you open the eyes that look inside, you shut off the you shut off all the connection to the outside world. And you switch on the connection to the inside world. That is the way to open your real eyes.
Okay.
Thank you.
From
Facebook, I have a question. What was your moment that changed your spiritual thinking forever? Actually, my moment was on 31st August, 2 days back. 2 days back, many people, I think many of you, I think Sudeep also said, they call it Happy Enlightenment Day. I'm not sure. Sudeep, send it. Sudeep, you send, I think. Greetings. So, there comes a time, you know this, have you heard this, who was that scientist who said, Eureka, Galileo, is it?
Archimedes, sir.
Archimedes. Archimedes principle, when he was in the tub, right? And the buoyancy principle came to his mind, correct? I have forgotten my school, what I studied in school, I have completely forgotten that. So, Archimedes, when he, Eureka, he jumped out of the bathtub, not knowing he's not wearing any clothes. And he started running in the streets. People said, Pagal, madman, he's become mad without any clothes. He's wearing no clothes. He's running and he's shouting, Eureka, 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 Eureka. He got the realization. So, what was your moment that changed the spirit? Been thinking forever. When I realized one day, hello, you are not my name. They used to call me Ravi Melwani. One day I realized after 48 years, you are not Ravi Melwani. After 48 years, I wish Rajendra Makwani realizes one day I am not Rajendra Makwani. It is so difficult. No, it is not easy. It is not an easy subject. Wherever you go tomorrow, kaun hai? Main Rajendra hun. Who is this? I am Sudeep Bhargava. Yes, we are not able to identify. So what changed my life completely? What was it that changed my life completely forever? What is the moment? Was that aha. That aha. I suddenly felt this body is like this t-shirt. One day I felt, I don't know how to make you all feel this. I don't know whether you all can feel or you can't feel, but this is the feeling. Just like you know that this shirt is not you. You know Samita is wearing a salwar kameez or sari. You know, this is not me. This is my dress. But when you come to know that this is also my dress, when you come to know, then you realize you can feel you are that one who's wearing this body. I am not the body that I wear. I am the one who wears the body. This is the this is a very beautiful. See, let me tell you one thing. You know, suppose you're 50 of you or 60 of you coming on this call every day. Do you know 8 billion people are missing the most beautiful journey of their world? 8 billion people. How to make 8 billion people understand that they are not realizing the truth? 8 billion people don't realize what? There is a way to eternal happiness. All the time in the house, we are having jagada, this fighting, that fighting, this misunderstanding. Why? Because we don't realize this is natak. This is where Dattatreya, you have to open your real eyes. Not enough for you to listen to me and say outside, not, no. You must actually treat it like a drama. Nothing is real. When you start viewing everything as a drama, and then natak uska hai ye, sangeet bhi uski hai, hum to bas kalakar hain, hum aate hain jaate hain, marzi jo hai unki wo manzoor karna hai, ye jeevan unki kripa hai, humko arpan karna hai, hum to katputle dhaga unke haathon mein hai, hoga jo uski marzi hai, jeena marna to uske haathon mein hai, hum to kuch bhi nahi hai. You have to reach that level. Anything happening in your life, if somebody says you're a bloody fool, okay, thank you. Because why should you react? You should learn to watch everything. And the day when I realized everything was a drama, I just left everything. A day came, I had a very dedicated person who was with me for more than 25 years. I gave the checkbook. I gave the responsibility. I said, you sign checks. You take care. I am not doing from tomorrow morning. What do you mean? I said, from tomorrow, I will not sign any checks. On 31st of August, when it happened, 1st September, I gave checkbook and I gave my pen. I told, from today, I will not sign any check. You sign the checks. So you see, it is not an easy thing, right? Even crores of checks, and not like in company where three people sign.
Which year it was?
2014.
Okay.
1st September 2014. So Rajendra, at that particular time, suddenly I got one aha. suddenly you get one, that realization. The realization came, I am Atma in Ravi, Atma in Ravi. Then September, October, November, December, I kept on writing my name, Atma in Ravi, Atma in Ravi, Atma in Ravi. After 3 months, the short form came, Air. It took 3 months. After writing, what's your name? My name is Atma in Ravi. My name is Atma in Ravi. For 3 months, I called my name Atma in Ravi. Then in 2015, my name changed to Air. Okay, next question.
Ajitek,
please. Ajitek Dada.
Shivom, sir.
Shivom, Ajitek.
हाँ जी सर, अभी आप अपना वो एनलाइटनमेंट एक्सपीरियंस बता रहे थे, तो सर ये कब आपका ये हुआ था, उस टाइम क्या मोमेंट चल रहा था आसपास, क्या था? आप मेडिटेशन पोस्चर में बैठे हुए थे, ये क्या था?
मैं फ्लाइट में था, एयर फ्रांस AF-192 फ्रॉम पेरिस टू बैंगलोर. इट डिपार्टेड फ्रॉम पेरिस एट अबाउट आई थिंक 10:30 इन द मॉर्निंग or from 11 o'clock in the morning, right? It landed at 11 p.m. in the night in Bangalore. And for those 10 hours, I was just writing the book. That book is with me. And I kept on writing page after page after page after page. I must have written 30, 40, 50 pages. Am I the body? I am not the body. Am I the mind? I am not the mind. But I am. Who am I? If I am not the body, I am not the mind. Am I the ego? I am not the ego. What will happen after death? How will I be born again? Where is God? I kept on writing. Then all the spiritual, the jigsaw puzzle fell into place. Suddenly at 10 o'clock in the night before landing, whole flight, she came and asked, you'll have Indian food, you'll have Italian food, you'll have Chinese food. I said, I don't want anything. Coffee, water, coffee, Coca-Cola, water, coffee. That's all. I kept on drinking something throughout the flight. And before I landed, I got that moment of aha. 31st of August, 2014.
Sir, matlab aap enlightenment experience hone se pehle aap ye likhte rahe कि आई एम नॉट द बॉडी, आई एम नॉट द माइंड, आई एम नॉट द ईगो, ये सारा आप लिखते रहे तो आपको लास्ट में विद गॉड्स ग्रेस और आपके गुरुजी दादा दीपू आसवानी की ग्रेस की वजह से आपको एनलाइटनमेंट हो गया
प्लेन लैंड होने से पहले. एनलाइटनमेंट हो गया नहीं हो गया वो मैं नहीं बोल सकता हूँ. हाँ, मुझे एहसास हो गया, आई गॉट द रियलाइजेशन कि सच क्या है.
सर उस टाइम क्या हुआ, क्या था आपके साथ, क्या एक जब आपके साथ आहा मोमेंट हुआ तो क्या हुआ आपके साथ?
अरे ये हुआ कि अचानक, सपोज अचानक आपको कोई बोले, डोंट प्लीज डोंट मिस्टेक व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, अचानक आपको आके कोई बोले तुम्हारा माँ बाप नहीं है, तो कैसे फील होगा आपको? अचानक कोई आके बोलता है, अरे तुम्हारा माँ बाप तो वो बाजू वाला गली में है, वो है तुम्हारा माँ बाप, सेम हो गया, अलग हो जाएगा.
हाँ जी सर.
तो यू विल बी लाइक अ फिश आउट ऑफ वाटर, राइट? यू विल फील लाइक सडनली माय मदर फादर फॉर 25 इयर्स आई एम लिविंग विद देम, सडनली आई कम टू नो टुमारो दे आर नॉट माय मदर एंड फादर. हाउ द फीलिंग कम्स. आई एम गिविंग अ वेरी रॉन्ग एग्जांपल, बट आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड. ये द पॉइंट व्हेन यू आर शेकन अप टू रियलाइज, सी व्हाट इज माय होल गोल ऑफ डूइंग दिस आस्क एयर. इफ एनी ऑफ यू reach that point of realization, which I don't know, many of you may have already reached, I don't know, but if any of you reach that point, it will liberate you from all suffering. So kya hoga, you're asking me kya hoga? Oh, it's a major, no pain of body, no misery of mind, no fear, no worry, no anxiety, no anger, no hate, no revenge, no ego.
Sir, main ye janna cha raha tha, jaise jab aapka ye aha moment hua, तो कुछ कहते हैं, कोई लोग कहते हैं कि बॉडी फ्रीज हो जाती है, मतलब ये क्या, मतलब पता नहीं, क्योंकि सर मेरे तो एक्सपीरियंस में भी है नहीं,
वो कुछ नहीं होता है, ये सब ड्रामाबाजी है. ये सब ड्रामाबाजी है, ये आप मत यकीन करो, बिकॉज ये कुछ लोग हैं ना, इसको ड्रामेटाइज करते हैं. कुछ लोग बोलते हैं कि सर के ऊपर एक राउंड भी आ जाता है, हेलो पता है क्या, ऐसा एक लाइट आ जाता है, पीछे से बल्ब आना है क्या, पीछे से छोटा एक लैंप बल्ब मार के एक लाइट भी आना है क्या, ये सब बकवास है. लेट्स नॉट गेट कैरिड अवे बाय दीज फेरी टेल्स. what is important is to understand that this one transforms your life. It changes, shifts your paradigm. It's a paradigm shift. It completely transforms your life. Imagine, okay, let me give you one more example. Aap aisa bol rahe na? Imagine one day, Ajitek, you are a caterpillar and you are crawling. Achanak, ek din, aapke pankh ho gaye, aap udna shuru kiye, you became a butterfly, you start flying. What is the experience? Can you tell me? How do you feel?
Blissful experience, sir.
That's a completely different, na? I thought I was a worm. I thought I was a dirty worm crawling and eating cabbages. Suddenly, I see I'm not a worm. Suddenly, I got wings to fly. Suddenly, I'm a beautiful butterfly. This is called metamorphosis. It is a metamorphosis. So, Ajitek, you experience a metamorphosis, a complete change in your paradigm, in your being, in your experience.
अच्छा सर, मतलब ये जो ऐसे कहते हैं कि बॉडी नहीं रहती है, फ्रीज हो जाती है, कुछ बॉडी का एहसास नहीं होता, थॉटलेस स्टेट हो जाता है, तो वो सब ऐसे फेरी टेल्स है ये सारा ही?
आई डोंट, सुनो, वो किसी के हो, किसी का हो ना हो, आई डोंट नो, बट ऐसा नहीं कि ऐसा होना चाहिए, ये तो श्योर है. ऐसा ही होना चाहिए तो नहीं है. किसी का बॉडी फ्रीज हो गया, पता नहीं उसने क्या किया, उसने क्या पिया खाया, आई डोंट नो. टांग सो जाता है, मालूम होता है, नहीं होता है पूरा, दोनों टांग, यू फील पिंस आर प्रिकिंग, यू फील नो ब्लड सर्कुलेशन, होता है कि नहीं होता है?
यस सर.
हाँ, तो वो भी हो सकता, वो तो कॉमन है ना, सबको होता है, एवरीबडी. Bridget, when you are folding your legs and sitting after two hours, when you wake up, there is no blood circulation. Your legs are feeling numb. It happens, right? It's a common phenomena. It's a scientific phenomena.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Shivam.
Thank you, Shivam.
Bridget says today is your real birthday and she's wishing you happy Bridget, birthday.
Bridget, I am not birth. Bridget, I am birthless. I am birthless and deathless. Bridget, thank you for your birthday. Thank you for your birthday wishes. But I am birthless. I am never born. And I will never die. Yeah. My body will die. My body will die.
It's only the name is birth.
Yeah. Only the body. The body is birthday.
No. It says body. Yes.
The body has birthday, but not me.
No, exactly. Yeah. It's the name birthday.
It's the name. Yeah, the name has a birthday. The body has a birthday, but not you. Bridget has birthday, but not you. You are not Bridget. You are the soul in Bridget.
Yes.
S-I-B. S-I-B. Soul in Bridget.
Yes.
S-I-B.
Yes.
Sudeep Bhargava.
Shivam, sir.
Shivam.
So just one small check that I wanted to make. Yesterday, we were talking about Leela and Karma. Leela and Maya. Is my understanding correct that Leela is that power? The Maya will be the power which will make the Leela look like real. It's like Leela is a two-dimensional show, but the Maya will be that 3D glasses. It will make it appear that something is coming towards you.
Your mind is always overthinking.
Uh-huh. At times it doesn't. That's why I keep checking it with you.
Sorry. So Sudeep, it's like this, Sudeep. There is one divine power. The power of the Paramatma. You understand that? There is a power of God called the power of Paramatma. Correct? That power has constituted or instituted Maya. The Maya has been constituted, instituted by God. And the power has got two powers. The power to project the myth and to conceal the truth. This is one aspect of this samsara. The other aspect of this samsara is Leela. Leela is controlled by karma. What is happening in the Leela is controlled by the law of karma. But whatever is happening in this Leela and Karma is all under the influence of Maya. So they are different attributes of the divine. You can't try to connect and say the mountains and the ocean. What is the connection of the mountain and the ocean? No, both are coexisting. Right? You got the point with it? So there's no need of trying to connect Maya and Leela. Maya is a power. Leela is the show. We don't know whether we cannot go backwards to God at that point of the master, the cause, the causeless cause. We cannot go and understand what God has done, why God has done. Nobody can tell why God made the grass green, why he did not make the grass red. Rajendra Bhakana, you know, did you ask God, Rajendra? Aap to red t-shirt pehna hai. Aap kyun grass bhi red nahi kyun nahi hua? So very difficult, right? This is the will of God.
I am completely surrendered.
That is the right way. That is the way to live. Prabhu, aap grass ko purple banao na, manzoor hai. Aap grass ko nikal bhi do na, wo bhi manzoor hai. Suppose Prabhu, tomorrow God creates, no, you don't breathe in oxygen, you must breathe carbon dioxide. Jo bhi aapka marzi hai. Prabhu, kal, at the stroke of midnight, God changes. Man will breathe carbon dioxide and plants will breathe oxygen. Sudeep, can we have to accept it or we will say, no, God cannot.
We'll have to accept it, sir.
We have to accept. At the stroke, sometimes in Europe, no, it'll be 12 o'clock night. Suddenly they will say, okay, daylight change. Everybody turn your clock from 12 o'clock to 11 o'clock. Arey, ye kya hua? Sabne ghanti ek ghanta back kar diya. Everybody has to do. Nobody can question. It is the rule of the government. Change the clock 1 hour. Suddenly, Kumar Swami will know. In America also they do it. Kumar Swami. Suddenly they will say, no, change the clock 1 hour forward. Change the... what is, in India, we don't know. In India, we tell the Gaonwala, change the clock 1 hour forward and 1 hour back. The Bihari Babu will tell you, are Modi ji, hum kyun kare? Tumhara baap ka maal hai kya? 1 hour clock. तुम्हारा हमारा 1 hour क्यों ले लिया हम हमारा वापस हम 1 hour बहुत कीमती है इंडिया में यू हैव टू आंसर 1000 मिलियन पीपल हैव टू 1 hour क्लॉक व्हाई यू मूव फॉरवर्ड एंड बैकवर्ड बट इन अमेरिका दे कीप क्वाइट दे जस्ट डू इट दे डोंट आस्क क्वेश्चंस कुमार स्वामी इज देयर अ स्ट्राइक इन अमेरिका ऑन द स्ट्रीट बिकॉज पीपल आर चेंज द क्लॉक डज एवरीबॉडी गो फॉर स्ट्राइक इन द रोड इन अमेरिका ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन So, my dear friends, with that, see, so every day, our ask air, as I told you, every day we take new. Today, why I wanted you to understand fourth factor. Remember, there's a power called miracle. You know what man believes? Man believes that he can make the impossible possible. A man believes that he can make the impossible possible. But what man doesn't understand that without the grace of the fourth factor, even the possible will become impossible. Man thinks he can make the impossible possible. But sometimes man doesn't, he becomes so helpless that the possible becomes impossible. Sometimes there are people in outer space and the spacecraft is going. Suddenly we don't know what happened. The motor stops. And they get shivered. They shiver like fish out of water. And they don't know what to do. But suddenly after 5 minutes, the motor comes on. What happened? Nobody can explain what happens. Surinder Goyal, happy birthday, auspicious in all respects. May all the means be fruitful and give you victory, happiness, prosperity. Be Akshay eternal in your life. Happy birthday. Surinder Goyal, आप तो anesthesia doctor है यार आपको आपको तो पता है लोगों को कैसे knockout करते हैं हाँ so Surinder Goyal, you are the expert in making knockout and then you after knockout you bring them back but Surinder Goyal knows you know he's a doctor some patients I don't know whether you know this or you don't know this some patients when you give general anesthesia they cannot come back. Do you all know that? Some patients, when you give anesthesia, the doctors are very, very scared because they don't come out of the anesthesia. They remain there forever and they die. So we are birthless and we are deathless, and we have to realize this, and we have to understand the power of the fourth factor. And for the rest of the questions, like the TV serials always say in the end, to be continued tomorrow. I bow down to you. Thank you.